When my brother Ben and I were small boys living with our grandparents Tom and Lizzie Elliott on their farm in Macoupin, Kentucky, we witnessed an unforgettable tragedy. Our great Uncle Bill and Aunt Ella's house burned down. I guess if you compared this to disasters of the day, maybe it wouldn't seem noteworthy, but for us, for them, Uncle Bill and Aunt Ella, it was devastating. It's one of the things that happen when you're young and you carry it with you forever. Anyway, Uncle Bill and Aunt Ella's great-granddaughter, Carla Elliott Sieka, hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, knew that my brother and I were there at the time and witnessed it. And she asked if I could send her my memory of that particular day. She was just a baby and had no recollection. It's a word I haven't used for a while, of her great-grandparents. I think she may have had a photo of herself as a baby in her arms, possibly. Anyway, I sent her an email describing the events that I remembered, and she apparently shared it with her children. And so I just finished writing a song about it, and I call it The Fire. A black cloud rolling o'er the hills of yonder. He can smell the smoke, but he can't see the fire where there's smoke. There must be fire. Do you boys see that smoke rising? Could it be Brother Bill and Ella's barn a-burning? Come on, boys, let's go. Where there's smoke, there must be fire. His big plow shoes marred in the mud by the ruts of the old dirt road. But that doesn't slow his pace. He up and runs a little faster. Oh my Lord, it's not the barn that's a burning. It's the house, it's on fire. Memories of those flames right before their eyes. Sits in her wheelchair outside the house as it burns, pleading, oh my dear Bill, don't go back in. Oh please Bill, don't go in again. Oh please Bill, don't go back in. Yeah. was a light at the end of the tunnel.